how I first entered, like, watching the, you know, Skeptosphere videos. Because it all started when I was, like, fucking... Fuck, this started in, like, 2015. Jesus Christ, that was a while ago. It all started with me watching just shit, being, like, 12 years old or whatever. I don't remember exactly the age. Or exactly the... And just watching, like, oh, man, stupid people on Twitter... And at some point, I was like, man, I want to watch really stupid things that people say on Twitter on YouTube.com. So I, like, YouTube searched it or whatever. I found, like, this Andy Worski fella, right? And I was like, oh, wow, these are funny videos of people that are very dumb on Twitter. And then the content slowly transitioned over to stupid people on Twitter to stupid SJWs. And then from there, yikes happened to me. A lot of yikes. Where I was just like, I never fully agreed with anything that happened. Whenever, I think Andy's, like, dumb. But I think, for me personally, I relate with that man the most, in terms of everyone in the Skeptosphere, because I just think he's an idiot, and I think I'm an idiot. And I think he just kind of just got trapped in there. Wasn't really lucky. So that's where that all started, and I got into that, and I started, like, I watched a little bit of Armor Skeptic, but I don't know. I never watched Sargon of Akkad. For my entire existence, I've never thought that man was smart or intelligent. I think any human in this world would agree that Sargon of Akkad, that YouTuber, is a fucking aught. Who maybe doesn't know how to read. Yeah, that's really interesting. I like this new meme of YouTube content and, like, that one guy, what was his name? He was wearing the fucking gorilla shirt, I think. Where he talked about how he got sucked into, like, the fucking the funnel of the alt-right. I'm glad that stuff is surfacing, because it's very interesting how all of that, like, happened. Someone that convinced me a lot, kind of, was Thunderfoot, but that's just because most of his shit is Science Boy, and man, I think he really wanted to fuck Anidia Sarkeesian Thunderfoot. Dude, he needed that puss-puss, alright? You know how many videos he has of that one person? Oh man, like, a solid amount of it is out of context. Very interesting. Very interesting subsection of YouTube. I like his science videos, he does okay at it. Now we go into part two. My way out of that Skeptosphere. It originally started with a couple of H-Bomber Guy videos. Because I found him, the first video I watched of his was, was it review or I'm gonna say review. I think it might have been analysis, but of Lisa the Painful, or just Lisa. I think it was all three that he was focusing on. I never actually finished that game, you know? It's a good game, you know? I think most people can it's not making any sense. Lisa the Painful is a good game. I liked it, but I gave up because I got slightly depresso. That's back in the day. I need to replay it, you know? Anyways, it all started with that shit where I agreed with, like, almost everything he said, but whenever he made a joke, I took it seriously, and I'm like, man, this guy sounds like such an idiot. But then eventually, I started transitioning. I don't know when, but I just started, like, I stopped watching, you know, right-wing content, or just, like, Skeptosphere content. It's not good with alt-right content. Never started watching fucking Stefan Molyneux. Never started watching, Sargon. So I think we're safe. I always stayed on the surface. On the center side of it. Yeah, watching shit like H Bomber Guy and some of his videos. His fucking LUT. I hate how saturated his fucking videos are. The LUT is just like, it hurts the soul. I don't like it. His blues look so fucking blue. I can't handle it. I think my IL for old site is 206, by the way, so we're not getting that, don't worry. Alright. But yeah, like, shit like that. Shit like Sean. Sean was boring. I never could handle Sean videos. I still can't. There's facts and knowledge. I can't take it. It hurts. Why am I greasy? I look greasy, but I'm not. Fuck. Sorry, one sec. Okay. I'm trying to wake up. Alright. The Skeptosphere. So that's my meme. I always stayed very centrist in it. You know? In terms of how deep I went. Because I don't think my opinions ever changed when watching their videos. I just thought there was just more stupid people. You know what a real problem with me is, alright? Is usually when I come across someone that sounds like they're being a racist, a real problem is I just assume that they're an idiot and not that they're a racist. Because more than likely, I'm wrong and they're a racist and not an idiot. But I'm like, come on, they gotta just be an idiot, right? They gotta just not have the very basic facts, right? Please? John Tron, don't say that wealthy blacks cause more crimes than poor whites. Oh my god, he said it. Oh my god, I don't know. Is he an idiot or is he a racist? I don't know. It's a scary world we live in. Ethnostate. This is a conversation you should never have. You lose half of your audience when you talk seriously. Not even seriously. I physically don't have the ability to talk seriously. Because I have zero knowledge on anything that I talk about. I don't research it. I really need to, like, write down things that I either need to research or, like, increase my vocabulary. Because if you probably have already noticed, hopefully, that I have a very limited vocabulary. English is my first language and I barely know any of it. Alright, I failed English 9th grade twice. I'm still in English 9. Like, I would not consider myself great in the art of speaking English. I know people from countries that primarily don't speak English, that speak very well at the English language. See, very well, that's not how you... It's not how you say the words. It's not grammatically correct. It's crazy. It's crazy how uneducated I am. How not smart I am as a person. Alright, new topic. Because I don't actually remember any of the topic that I was... I don't remember much of that whole Skeptosphere part of my life. I just remember that I was like, thought it was kind of dumb. Alright. But back to part two where I was like getting out. Right, primarily watched Andy Worski's videos. So I think that puts me in the safe zone because that means I was just watching idiot, retarded person do that right-wing shit and not actual Nazis. He was like trying to find shit that was SJW when it just like wasn't. It was just stupid people. And like I started, I think when I unsubbed from Andy, that's when I like got out. But like I never got far. I never really did. I'm still subbed to Chris Raygun, you know? But thank God I don't look at his Twitter. That was a really good time, holy fuck. Oh, there's anger. That's a fucking problem I have. Whenever I hear someone in that household, I like instinctively like have to look at the audio to see if it was picked up or not. But like, I really shouldn't, because that will, looking at it makes me angry, or I fucking die because I'm not looking at the screen. Usually it's not picked up. Almost any time I like think that it's getting picked up, it is honestly not getting picked up in any way. Unless I'm talking, you physically cannot hear any background noise that actually happens. Alright. Ah, fuck. There was a topic in my brain, but I forgot. Ooh. There's a gamer in chat. I need you to force me to get on some fucking topic. Ooh, imagine dying in this room. That is interesting. Because the way I got into that topic was random. That was luck. That was pure luck. Alright, you know what? Imagine dying twice on the two easiest rooms of Oshiro. It's gotta be something that I know a solid amount of that I can talk about a little bit. I can talk about how I got mod in someone's Twitch chat by stealing their content. That was interesting. Oof. That's a very short discussion. I'm pretty sure I've talked about it enough. I brought it up so many times in my life. Because I think it's fucking hilarious. That is some solid time save. Ooh, Zooey Mama. Fucking last night at, I think it was at 1,000 meters. I was at like minus 1 minute and 30 seconds. Then on easy clap, I was plus 1 minute. Ah! What is a solid topic? Oh right, I'm doing the meme where I got mod in someone's chat by stealing their content. So, 72 degrees in here, fuck dude. Clint Stevens' videos are like, okay, I liked them. I don't that much anymore, but I liked them at the time, you know, a couple months ago, like half a year ago. So I was like, hey, I want to do, like, Twitch highlights for someone. And I'm, like, searching, I'm like, man, who do I follow on Twitch that, like, is, like, entertaining enough for me to watch and has enough people clipping their shit so I can just steal clips and, like, also doesn't already have YouTube videos of their Twitch content? And I'm like, oh my god, I found them. Yeah, sure, he's a better streamer than me. MSushi100. I think he's like third place in this game. But I originally found him through, Portal. Or Portal 2, actually. Which apparently he's been playing for a while. Since he was a fucking kid, since he was a squeaker. Oh right, so I originally found him through Portal because, ya boy. Why am I not wall jumping there? Ya boy made a texture pack for Portal 2. This is back in January 2019. Where I made a texture pack where everything was Knuckles. Remember that? Remember Ugandan Knuckles? Remember that meme? I turned everything into Knuckles. There was so many Knuckles. I think I had like at least 6 speedrunners of the game play it. I played it after I watched like five of them do it. And I understand why I caused them like actual pain. Because I don't even know how to speedrun that game. My fastest time, I think, still on there, like 3 years ago, and it's like an hour. Or 2 hours or something. It was, yeah, because the speedrun for it, fastest time is about an hour for World 2. So it was like a 2 hour speedrun. But my fucking knuckles percent of it, it's like three or four hours, and I did it, made it through. Knuckles percent. It's an actual category on speedrun.com, the extended categories for Portal 2. And find Knuckles percent. Yeah. I'm very sad that I've made that mark on the world. But I'm glad no one's gonna find it. The only people that have speedrun that game are Keegan and some people that wanted to fucking bully Keegan. Because no one likes Keegan. Shouldn't say that. I'm pretty sure he's either just like an actual aut or just a child who can't understand social cues and such. I think there's a way to go faster there. I'm going to assume he's just a child and that's why he doesn't understand a couple of social cues. Like, hey, no one cares about your fucking Twitch channel. Said it yourself that you have your own Discord or your Twitch. Why are you in this server talking about it? I'm sorry, Chief, but if I actually cared about you, I'd be in your fucking Discord. So, you know, kind of meme, but it's the real world, boys. If someone actually cares about your shit, they'll go to the hub to find out about your shit. Don't go in other people's Discord. Fucking, it's like going to Commander Root's chat and be like, please, follow for follow, lurk for lurk. Please, I need twisty wooers. I ain't talking shit about you. Don't need to worry. It's some other Keegan. All right, I don't think you even have a Twitch. What the fuck? I have 5 IQ. No, I'm talking about some other Keegan. He's like 12 years old. Or 14, actually. I think you said it before. I think he's like 14. Now that Keegan. Ooh. That's who I'm talking about. I'd never be talking about you, my home slice. Yeah, I was about to. That was a close one. I had to go dig deep inside my soul to not do it. Let's go. Another meme review topic. What is a good meme review topic? What the fuck? Spot, you better fuck off, alright? Buddy? Alright. Handling one person that calls me Keck is enough. I can't handle more than one person. Alright, the Keck crew is not one I can respect. Oh no. Yeah, that's what I thought, buddy. Yeah, I knew it. Yeah. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, Keck me. Alright, we didn't need those 20 seconds. It's all good. I'm sorry about that. That yikes. I'm gonna die. It's alright. I'm doing okay. I'm doing just fine. I'm doing okay. You've never seen someone so good at this game. Holy shit. Easy clap, by the way. Alright, listen, I don't want degenerates in my chat, alright? People are gonna think I'm a degenerate if I have degenerates in my chat. You gotta get out of here before it's too late. Or if people get disappointed. How dare you fucking boost my viewer count? You absolute mongoloids, you absolute squares, I should say. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Ooh! That'll do it. Alright, you know what? But they can't know that. I don't want them to find out that I'm actually a degenerate. Alright? Because I don't even know what that word means. So I don't know why I say it. Alive? What? I've 100% got fucking squished like an elevator shaft. You know that meme? That's what happened right there. I should be dead. Split in two. Oh, that's gonna be a yeah. Oh, right. How I died twice in that long boy room. Sorry, sir. I just don't know how to play the game. Give me a moment. Oh, God. That's pretty sad, because I don't like you. That's how you increase. Oh, no! I'm still gonna be in the green. If I try hard enough. If I try hard 7. And I make it look easy, I really do. Losing fucking 20 seconds. It's alright, I'm a god at Theo. I'm gonna die 0 times in Theo. Alright? It's the easiest part of the chapter. I'm not even gonna die in this room, which no one should ever die in. See? Alright, I usually die in that room a lot for fucking no reason. And I'm glad the gods have, small vocabulary, back at it again. Okay, sure, that works. Whatever, that's not how you do it. At all. But we made it. We're off to an okay start. Alright, new meme review talking point. Or topic. Give me something really, really stupid to talk about. Or just a thing to talk about. Because I can't be a boring Twitch streamer. I have to be cool and epic. As they say. I'm the best. This is an easy game. No need to worry. Alright, top player out there. Yikes. It's gonna be a zoinks for me, dog. That's gonna be a zoinks. Sure. Theory of multiple. Listen. Alright. So that reminded me of something. So. You know what really rustles my jimmies about time travel, alright? So. There's one theory that, like, I don't like this one that much, but I'm pretty sure it's the accepted one that, like, adds up. Where when you jump dimensions, because that's what it is, when you go through time, you're jumping dimensions. You're going from one plane of existence to another, right? And anime Hitler. Anyways, so there's two dimensions, all right, right? It's just that one of them is like a few seconds behind, right? This is your dimension, and this is the second dimension. Alright, when you jump, you just go up. Alright, you move through that fourth dimension. You never move through time. You just jump to a different dimension that's exactly the same as yours, but, like, a few seconds behind. Alright? Like, that's the meme, right? That's the meme about time travel. And usually people would be like, oh, man. You cut and paste, right? You take your consciousness and you jump into a new one. So, in your original universe, you just fucking die. Alright? That's just what happens. And you steal the soul of whatever you was living in that second timeline. That's like the best way to work with it. I like that, kind of. Because that, obviously everyone like that, so that's really good. But I like the copy and paste meta instead of cut and paste, where like you do it, you go through time, and there's like a 50% chance, technically, where you just split, alright? One of you stays and then it copies and gets sent to the second one. So like you like get your like time travel device, you press the button, and then like you just don't, and you're like, what the fuck? How did this happen? I think that one's interesting, because I was like thinking about this at some point, of some kind of like meme, right? Of some like you just watch someone go through their life with the ability to just go wow and jump through time, like back like 7 days or some meme, or like back 1 minute. But like it doesn't work every time, because it goes with that copy paste meme, so only like sometimes you'll actually jump through time. And then you just, and I imagine there's this one universe where you have this fucking insane dude trying to travel through time, but whoa, but every single time he's just so unlucky that it doesn't work. Anyway, that's my take on time travel. It's the wrong take. The right take is cut and paste. Alright. I gotta stop doing the slow stride here. Ooh, yikes. Theory about the fourth dimension. The fourth dimension... Oh. Thank you for the host, Joe. The fourth dimension, alright, is very interesting. I think there's different, like, memes about the fourth dimension, right? But for me personally, the fourth dimension is jumping through time. Yeah, at least in this situation. I do not know a lot about the fourth dimension, I'm sorry. I can't even imagine three-dimensional shapes in my head, alright? Can you stop posting shit? I don't even know how much of a meme review it is. Hit him with that 10-second ban. You're going away for a long time, buddy. Back in my day, the only trolls in my Minecraft stream were people I didn't know. But this is the 21st century, where all of your friends are absolute aughts. So, that's just how it is these days. Imagine dying in this room. Oh my god, Omega LOL. Am I right? Gamers. Alright, the fourth dimension meme was fun. I think I talked a little bit about the fourth dimension in terms of time travel. Because I don't know any... Because that's the only fourth dimension that I believe in. I mean, the simplest way, I guess, to visualize the fourth dimension is to be able to visualize how the second dimension views the third dimension. Or how to translate the second dimension to the third dimension. And once you can translate that, it should be easier to translate the third dimension to the fourth dimension, right? Like, I saw this video where people were playing 4D chess, where pretty much the first thing they did was made a your average 2D chess, took that, right, and split into like four quarters. And they were like, all right, we're gonna take this, and like if we were to visualize it in 3D, it would be layered on top of each other, these four planes of existence, these four planes of chess. And it's like, all right, so we're obviously not gonna play like that, but instead we play like that. We play 3D chess, but we have all those four separate planes laid out on a flat surface. So you're playing 3D chess on a 2D surface. So the way you play 4D chess is you pretty much play the 3D version of chess, alright? But four times. So between those four-dimensional planes. Fourth dimension is crazy, dog. I don't know. Again, can't visualize 3D. Alright, you listen here, buddy. You're probably right. But my brain is too smooth to understand you. You're gonna have to speak in simpler terms, alright? Oh yeah, I'm actually like really bad at chess. Who would have assumed? I'm like, what? The bottom 6th percentile? So I would say I'm pretty garbo. That's not the strat. I mean, it is the strat, but I'm not a speed boy, so I can't do that strat. Fourth dimension has some wacky shit. I mean, the fourth dimension is fun, you know, to just be like, wow, that's neat, to visualize in, like, third dimension. Because it makes it really simple. When you can translate 2D to 3D, you can translate 3D to 4D. I don't know how you translate 4D to 5- I should be dead. I don't know how to translate 4D to 5D, because I can't visualize 4D, so therefore I can not visualize 5D. But I can visualize 3 dimensions, which means I'm physically able to visualize 4 dimensions. You feel me? We live in a 3-dimensional world, so in theory we are should very easily be able to visualize the 4th dimension. But not the 5th one. That's one step too far. By the way, I failed English 9 twice. Just gotta make sure everyone knows I'm a brain lit. I'm talking about anything. Ooh, not the strat. I'm actually doing okay. I was gonna say I'm doing okay at the game, but I am in fact not. How do you discern directions in the fourth dimension? Because there's not up, down, left, right, forward, and back. There's now like two more, right? That adds up, right? Yes, right? And what in the second dimension there's four directions. The third dimension there's six. All right, wait, yeah. How many directions are there in the fourth dimension? I think it would be eight, right? I think I might be wrong here, though. Did you just fucking say three? What did you say before that? Hello? Disgusting. Can't even play the game. Oh my god. Alright, whether you like it or not, I'm dumping my fourth dimension theory on you the next time I catch you in a Discord channel. XYZ in time, yeah. See, no, because that's what I don't understand. I feel like there's two different ways to visualize the fourth dimension, right? Or, I can't visualize, you know? Where you have time. Alright, time. I don't like that. Alright, wait. Because the way I see it, the fourth dimension is like... The fourth dimension is pretty much like the third dimension. You know? Where... Here. This is how we visualize it. This is our two-dimensional plane. These are two-dimensional... Two-dimensional planes, which make a 3D space. So it is, you know, whatever, you know, X, Y, and then we have our Z of 2. right? And the way I imagine that is like this is our three-dimensional plane, and then this is a different fucking timeline. Right, I don't think you can physically go back in time. I just think you jump in a different fucking universe that happens to be further back in time. That happens to be like a few seconds behind the Big Bang, but everything else is exactly the same. Inevitable heat death of the universe. How about that? Dude, by the way, I'm gonna PB this, and whoever has to verify is gonna fucking watch this shit and be extremely disappointed. Gonna be so angry because I don't have a fucking clue about, sorry, wait, it's easier to visualize the fourth dimension if you consider the second. Oh. Alright, you know what? I don't know anything about the fourth dimension. Leave me alone. I shouldn't have talked about this in the first place. God damn it. I shouldn't have revealed my power level of being small brain. That's not the way you go, pal. That was fun. Figuring out how much I know about the fourth dimension and how much I don't know. That was interesting. I gotta yeet myself off this topic because I've been on it for long enough. Alright, I don't have any other topic. Fuck. I just sit in silence, alright, for these last like 10 minutes. Just complete silence. Okay, whoa, buddy. That is a paragraph. I'm gonna try to like slowly work through that. Every time we do. Alright. The second dimension is in the third scene as shadows. Alright. It's gonna be a while until I read that paragraph. Second dimension in the third is seen as shadows. Alright, I think that adds up, right? Oh, I get the analogy or whatever meme's going on here. But. Fuck. I just want to read the paragraph about how the fourth dimension works. Or a very basic version of how it works. By the way, losing like an hour here. As I fucked up. And these two dimensional objects are moved by the objects in the third dimension. Well, it can be, sure. See it. Whoa, buddy! Can you please, like, for a second, not die? You ever just do it correctly and then be very confused because you always do it the wrong way? Alright, I'm gonna. Alright, fuck trying to read that paragraph. I have to use, like, more than two of my brain cells to read it. So I'm gonna wait until the end of this run. Imagine I die in this room. Not even gonna pretend I'm gonna do that. I can, it's really easy to save like 5 seconds, but I don't trust my like fucking brain-lit mind. What? Gamer! This is what we in the industry call not it. Gee whiz. Was lucky. I shouldn't have made that. Fourth dimension is crazy, alright? I don't even know how the third dimension works. It's alright. I can't even play this 2D game, alright? Alright, so let's get on a more serious topic than the fourth dimension. I mean, like, come on. Alright, so in Minecraft porn, cube tits or round tits? I need to know. What is the preference here? Because my opinion is the cube tits, obviously. I mean, it's fucking Minecraft, right? Yeah, exactly. See, I've never met anyone that respects like the fucking the spherical tits in Minecraft porn, you know? It's just all right. If you're just going to like just staple them on, you do the square. But if you're going to go above and beyond, all right, maybe I can respect the Minecraft spherical tits, maybe. You got to have an argument, you know? And right now I haven't seen one. All right, they don't have respectable physics. I should have died right there. I don't know, man. Advocating for spherical Minecraft tits seems like a little sus. Alright, no, alright, listen, we're talking about Minecraft porn that actually has, like, a little bit of effort, alright? Hello. Man, I always forget that, because I only watch quality Minecraft porn. I always forget there's, like, a range where there's, like, that really garbage, like, Roblox-looking Minecraft porn. Alright, we're not talking about that. We're not talking about, like, that kind of quality. We're talking about a little better. We're not talking about freeze frames. Fuck that shit. I don't think you're talking about that either, so I'm big dumb. By the way, saving 9 years right here. Alright, we just lost 9 years. I really need a demo dash key button. Demo dash key only for door skip. 500 IQ. Oh man. Doing okay on time. I'm gonna lose it all here, don't worry. I'm gonna be like plus 1 minute, watch me. Okay, I think I'm like actually throwing. Like right after I say I'm going to throw, I like throw? I don't know, that seems a little sus. What the fuck did you just type in my chat? My holy scripture. Okay. Okay. Righty tighty. 5-hour ban. Got him. I'm doing pretty solid right now. Like Zoinks, man! Oh, okay, that angers me a lot. Oh, wait, alright. Fucking. One second, I gotta. All I saw was Roblox porn. I have to stop talking. I need to read this comment. No, alright, listen. Have you seen Roblox porn? Alright, you're making a really bold claim. To say Roblox porn is any good. Alright. The people that make Roblox porn aren't even fucking trying. They don't know how to make fucking animated, 3D animated, porn. They've never even tried in their life. They don't even use Blender or, like, Source Filmmaker. Don't use Source Filmmaker when making porn. Alright, use Blender. But, I don't even know what so far, the only Roblox porn I've seen, alright, is fucking still frames. Alright, buddy? And honestly, I can't respect that in my fucking video format. Like, alright, I can respect the frames, alright? But when I'm watching a video, that's not what I want. Fucking, like, speech bubbles and, like, in text that is, like, actually 2 pixels high. I can't watch that. That's too much for me. Oh no! I don't know why I don't fast fall there. Oh yeah, I'd like to thank everybody for being in this Twitch highlight. As long as I don't get another PB today, this is the one that's gonna be uploaded. Ooh, but I might not get a PB this time because I fucking yeeted myself right there. I have a lot of time. I could die like 3 more times and still, BB. I didn't want to say that when I was going through there. Because I was 100% jinx myself. I make it look easy. EB, hip hip hooray. If you've ever played Roblox as a youngin', then you've been in a server with a rape script before. Oh right, a script. Well obviously. I've personally never had that experience. Because I only played the basic bitch boy Roblox servers. No fucking tycoon. I was alright. 49 deaths. Let's get another PB. What? Excuse me? Splits? What happened?